Show of hands if there are any seats next to you that are available. Give me a count. Two over here, one here. There's four more seats in here, and looks like a few more out there as well. So if you send them in through the back if anybody else comes, and folks just raise your hand. Ames, y'all looking for a seat? Ames and Margaret, are you saving seats over there? All right, we got seats for you over here. Chamberlain family, report to the front row of the lobby over there, okay? Thank you. Anybody else need a seat? We got one here, and still two, anywhere else? One more over here. Okay, we got three individual seats at this point. All right. Back to you, sir.
Join us in singing Hallelujah Christmas. About this baby boy who's come to earth to bring us joy, and I just wanna sing this song to ya. It goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift. With every breath I'm singing Hallelujah, 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 Hallelujah. A couple came to Bethlehem, expecting child. They searched the inn to find a place, for you were coming soon. There was no room for them to stay, so in a manger filled with hay, God's only son was born. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. The shepherds left their flocks by night to see this baby wrapped in light. A host of angels led them all to you. It was just as the angel said, you'll find him in a manger bed. Emmanuel and Savior, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Shone bright up in the east to Bethlehem. The wise men three came many miles and journeyed long for you. And to the place at which you were, the frankincense and golden myrrh, they gave to you and cried out, Hallelujah, Hallelujah.
Thank you, folks. Good morning. No, good afternoon, people of God. Knew I was going to do that. Merry Christmas. Great to be together. It's finally here. We had this very lengthy fourth week of Advent, didn't we? It began this morning at 10 a.m. and now it's over. So the very short fourth week of Advent. Hope y'all have an amazing couple of days as we celebrate Christ's birth and come together as family and be aware of those who may not be celebrating as much as in previous years or missing someone. Thanks for all the ways in which you have a hand in this ministry. Your love, your energy, your time, your resources are what make this possible, and it's good to celebrate this night together. There really aren't that many announcements other than just be aware next Sunday, the 31st, 9 a.m. Contemporary, 11 a.m. Traditional, and also in between Fifth Sunday Fellowship Breakfast. So if you're looking for something to do next weekend to start off New Year's right, come on out to church and then stay for some breakfast and conversation in the community center during the 10 o'clock hour. No faith formation. And then we'll resume the schedule as usual on the 7th of January. Offices closed Monday and Tuesday this coming week, and also the Monday of January 1st as well for the holidays. Thanks for the gift of your presence and the gift you are to each other as we gather this night to consider God's good news becoming one with us. I'd like the Bader and Johnson families to come forward, lead us in lighting of the Christ candle. Thank you.
If you guys would like to stand and sing this next song with us, it's O Holy Night. Brightly shining, it is.
of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. A thrill of hope rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, come hear the angel voices. Oh, night Christ was born. Truly he taught us to love one another. His love is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy and grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Fall on your knees, come hear the angel voices. Oh, night divine, oh, night when Christ was born.
Please be seated. Kids, it's your time to shine a little bit. Come on up and share some life and love with Kat, right? There you go.
Thank you. So he's in that manger, right? Well, this baby doesn't have a place to sleep either. Do you think baby Jesus would be okay sharing the manger with this baby?
Yes.
Would you like to go put this baby in the manger with Jesus? Now, we know there were animals all around the baby Jesus. I've got this old dog here. She is so old and she's kind of rough, kind of looks like she's had a hard life. And I wonder if there's room for her with baby Jesus. Yes, and Brace is scooting for her as quickly as he can. Take that baby. Now, the baby we added to the manger might be hungry. Do you think baby Jesus would be okay with a can of food in there with him?
Yeah.
Okay. We can put a couple of cans in there. We'll have another kind of bring forward too. But if you don't have your cans, don't put it. I wonder who else there might be room for in that manger. When we were babies. Who else might Jesus want to make room for?
For a donkey.
For a donkey. Yeah.
For everything.
For love. Christmas Eve, and we pray all these things in your name. Amen.
so your sheep can use the feeding trough.
Oh, no, man, we're here to see the baby.
The baby? My baby?
Yes, ma'am, the angels came to us in the fields and told us all about your special child. They say he's the Messiah. We had to come see for ourselves.
Angels? Really? Hold on. Was one of them about this tall and a little, let's say, mischievous?
Oh, y'all met?
We met.
So sorry to disturb you, sir. We were just telling your wife here that the angels visited us in the fields to tell us the good news about your baby. That he's the Messiah, the Savior of all the world.
Can you believe it? God's own son, born in a barn, and I get to be his mother.
We need to tell the people this good news.
We need to tell everyone. Let's start by singing.
So you're going to sing, and I'd like to invite all the kids to come up, and you can bring your cans and put them in the manger, around the manger, and then sing along with Luke on some of the songs that you probably know best from Christmas.
Yeah, come on up.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming up, guys. You can get back to your seats. And, you know, you just sang songs. They sang songs with you. But the people who get this food are going to be singing songs of joy, too, because you were generous and shared food with them tonight. Thank you for doing that. Thank you so much. I heard a story this week that I wanted to share with you. It's been around for a while. I heard it a long time ago, but I want to share it with you again. And it reminds us of the importance of making room. There was a young girl who was so excited because they were getting ready to practice the nativity Christmas pageant at her church. And she was bound and determined to be Mary. So she showed up at the first meeting, at the first gathering, and they divided up parts and they looked around. And she got really frustrated because she did not get the part of Mary. In fact, the part that she was given was the innkeeper, all right, the innkeeper. So she was disappointed. But she decided and talked with her parents and decided, we'll make the best of this. So she was going to be the innkeeper. But she found a way to make it her very own. The night came of the pageant, and much like you heard in our story a little while ago, Mary and Joseph come and knock at the door, and the innkeeper comes out, and Mary and Joseph say, there's no place to stay. Do you have a room we can stay in? We're about to have a baby. And she had thought for a little while about what was the appropriate thing to say. And she said, absolutely, I've got the best room in the inn. She said, you can have my room. Come on in. Well, at first, it was kind of silent in the congregation when she dropped that line. But then all of a sudden, laughter broke out and a whole lot of smiles around the room. And I guess you could say what she did was she realized something. She made room, didn't she? She realized that there would always be some room if we look at things from God's perspective. So driving home in the car, Mom and Dad were just waiting to have conversation. And they asked her, why did you say what you said? And she said, well, you've taught me all my life, all the way up to about 7 or 8 or 9 years old. You've taught me all my life. What would Jesus want me to do? What would Jesus want me to do? And she said, it's obvious, isn't it, that Jesus would make room. So tonight we celebrate a God who makes room for us in God's heart. And through this gift of the Christ child, that love becomes embodied for us to share. So that there's always room. There's always more of God's love to be shared. And then, like those shocked shepherds and surprised Mary, God says, and I need you to help. It's your job, it's your work, it's your life to be the body of Christ today. Let's turn toward a poem that we'll share, and it's called There Is Room by Sarah R. Speed. It is by our friends at the Sanctified Art. As we've thought about how do we rejoice in a weary world, follow along as I read this. The world may feel like one long stretch of night, like an endless winter or a hovering rain cloud. And life may feel like walking into the wind, an uphill climb in every direction. But we can still open the door. We can't calm every storm, but we can turn on the porch lights and keep one eye checking outside. We can add chairs to the table. We can keep clean sheets on the guest bed. We can hold the elevator and learn pronouns. We can tell stories of belonging. We can take turns listening to each other. We can learn each other's names. We can plant trees for our children. We can study privilege and advocate for refugees. We can insist every day in a million ways. There is room. There is room. There is room for you here. We can't calm every storm, but we can turn on the porch lights and keep one eye checking beyond ourselves.
Please stand and join us in singing God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen. And you are allowed to dance if you want to.
us off from Satan's power when we're gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. From God our Heavenly Father, this blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same. How that in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.